The following is a lecture given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in the summer of 1966 in New York.
Now, some of your members asked me to explain the meaning of this chanting. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Now, this sound is transcendental sound. Transcendental sound, incarnation, sound incarnation of the Absolute Truth. Just try to understand what is incarnation. Incarnation means, the Sanskrit word avatar, and that is translated into English as incarnation. Of course, the root meaning of incarnation I cannot exactly explain to you, but the root meaning of the the root meaning of avatar is, which comes from the transcendental sky, the spiritual sky, to the material sky. That is called avatar. Avataran. Avataran, just like avataran means coming from up to down. That is called avataran. And avatar is understood that when God or His bona fide representative comes from that sky to this material plane, that is called avatar. So this sound, this Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, is a sound representation of the Supreme Lord. The Sarvam Khalidam Brahma, the whole thing, either material or spiritual, whatever we have got experience, nothing is separated from the Supreme Absolute Truth. Nothing is separate. Everything has emanated from the Absolute Truth. Come on, sit down. But just like the example, just like earth. Earth, then from earth you have got wood, fuel. From fuel, when you get fire, first of all there is smoke. Then after smoke, there is fire. And the fire, from fire you can take work. Now, beginning from earth there is wood, from wood there is smoke, from smoke there is fire. There is a link between the fire and the earth. But the work of the fire, the benefit of the fire, can be had at the last stage, when there is real ignition of fire. Similarly, there is link. The whole material cosmic situation, manifestation, what we see, it is just like the smoke. The fire is behind it, that is spiritual sky. But still, in the smoke, you can feel some heat also. So similarly, this sound vibration of the spiritual world is here, so that even in this material world, where there is a scarcity of that spiritual fire, we can appreciate, we can feel the warmth of that fire. So this is the meaning of, in a nutshell, meaning of this, spiritual vibration. And grammatical meaning is, all these words, 16 words, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. 16. Now, according to grammatical rules, when somebody is addressed, just like in your English language, it is not a address is, Oh, Mr. Such and Such. Similarly, in grammar, Sanskrit grammar, the same note of address, which is called Sambodhan, that is expressed in this way. So, Hare is the note of address form of the sound Hara. Hara. Hara means the potency of the Supreme Lord. Potency. The Supreme Lord is represented everywhere by His potency. There is a nice verse in the Vishnu Purana. It is said like that. Just like a fire. The fire situated in one place, it distributes its heat and light. Just like, take the example for the sun. The sun is located at a certain fixed up place that we can see. But the heat of the sun and the light of the sun is distributed all over the universe. Eka desha sthita shagne. Yes, the verse is like, Eka desha sthita shagne jatha josna vistar, josna vistarina jatha tatha sarvam akhilam jagat brahmanasakti. Akhilam jagat. In this world, whatever you are seeing, it is nothing but distribution of the energy of the Supreme Lord. Just like you can feel the light and the heat of the sun. This light and heat of the sun are different energies of the sun. The energy and the energetic, the thing from which the energy is generated and the energy, they are non-different. The sun sign or the sun heat is not different from the sun, because there is heat in the sun, therefore we feel the heat of sunshine. And there is light in the sun, therefore we see the sunshine. So this sunshine and sun heat is not different from the sun as it is, but still it is different. Still it is different. You cannot say that because I am feeling the heat of the sun, therefore I have approached sun. No. Sun is far, far away from you. And because the sun sign has entered your room, you cannot say that sun has entered my room. No. Still, sunshine and sun heat is not different from the sun. Similarly, the whole creation, anything, generally there are three things. The potent God and His three energies. This is the sum total. Internal energy, external energy, and marginal energy. External energy is this material manifestation. Just like this body is my external energy. I am soul. So my external energy is this body. Similarly, I have got my internal energy. That is my consciousness. Consciousness is my internal energy. And this body and the mind and this material demonstration or manifestation is my external energy. The body has developed, the mind has developed from me, soul. Not that I, consciousness is developed from this body. No, that is a wrong conception. That is a wrong conception. You cannot develop consciousness from this body. Otherwise, a dead man could have been again revived to consciousness. Because if matter is the cause of consciousness, then the whole matter is there already. Whole matter, the dead body means, so far material substance is concerned, everything is there, present. Nothing has disappeared. If you say there is no blood, that is not very difficult thing. Blood, a red substance. Do you mean to say something red injected within this body will bring back the life? No. If redness is the cause of life or consciousness, then modern chemical can make immediately by chemical combination the whole thing red. Or take the example, there are many natural stones. They are by nature red. If you say that this artificial redness cannot give life, the natural redness is the cause of life, then you take the stone, it has got natural redness, but there is no life. So redness is also not the cause of the consciousness of life. That is the wrong theory. There is a complete consciousness is completely different thing, qualitatively different. Nothing is different from one to another. Just like I have explained already, that the earth, wood, then smoke, then fire, everything is linked up. But everything is also different from one another. So, the whole thing, the Supreme Lord is represented throughout everything, whatever you see, matter or spirit or anything, physical, chemical, whatever you can give them, there are so many things. But they are not separated from God. God is linked up in everywhere. Isha vasamidam sarvam. Just like our Bhagavad Gita we have begun, jena sarvam idam tatam. That thing which is present all over the body, that you are. So, this is individual consciousness. I am present all over my body. Similarly, the Supreme Consciousness, He is present all over the universe. All over. This is only a small manifestation of God's energy, very minute. In the Bhagavad Gita, I will find, ekaṁ sinastitu jagat. This jagat means this material manifestation. this material manifestation is a 1/4 part demonstration of this whole energy of the Supreme Lord. 1/4 part. So, nothing is different from God. But there are certain philosophers, they say pantheist or monotheist, there are so many theists, they are also they believe in the Supreme, but impersonal. But we, followers of this Krishna philosophy, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavat, we do not follow that philosophy. What is that philosophy? The other section, they say, because God is distributed all over, everywhere, therefore there is no separate existence apart. But we do not say that. We say that, the example, that because the sun is distributing his heat and energy, therefore you cannot say that there is no existence of sun. Sun is separately existing. In spite of distributing for millions of years heat, the reservation of heat in the sun is intact. It is not diminished. But everyone knows that for millions and billions of years the sun is distributing heat. Nobody knows the history, how long. Your distributing center, the powerhouse, if you fail to supply coal or oil, then after 1 hour the whole New York City will be dark. Just you can imagine who is supplying the fuel in the heat of the sun, so that for millions and billions of years this heat of the sun is in the same temperature. So this is only one of the creation of the God, God's creation. But just imagine, if God's creation is so unlimited and so much energetic, then how much energetic and how much powerful is the Creator? That is to be seen. These things are to be thought. In everything we can have God consciousness. If this watch is a so wonderful workmanship, and we here and struck with wonder how nicely it is giving time, how the machine is adjusted. Now, before appreciating this watch, how much we have to appreciate the person who has discovered this watch? How much brain he has got? Before appreciating a powerful brain in this world, one should appreciate who has given him this powerful brain. If the man has attained that powerful brain out of his own accord, then great powerful brain like Professor Einstein, Sir Jagadish Chandra Bose, they could create another brain like them, so that in their absence there would not have been scarcity of scientists and powerful brain. But they could not do that. Therefore they are not creator of the powerful brain. The powerful brain is gift of the supreme powerful brain. So in every respect, if we think, this is called philosophy, if we have got thoughtful propensities, if we can little think over every matter, you will find that God is present everywhere. And still, He is personally present in His own place. The same example, the sun is present everywhere by heat and light. Still, the sun has its own location. That you cannot deny. Similarly, God is present everywhere. Not only everywhere, we learn from Brahma Sanghita. Eka pasau rachayatam jagadanna koti jachatirasti jagadanna chayajadantam annantarastham paramanuchayantarastham govindam adipurusam tamaham bhajami. This Govinda, anadiradi Govinda. So the prayer is, I worship that Govinda. Sarva karana karanam. Karana, who is the cause of all causes? Cause of all causes. Now, in this verse of Brahma Sanghita, we find that one of his plenary portions Vedic hymns, we find that God has become many. Eka bahushyam. God is one without second, but He has become Himself many. We are also God. Out of that many, we are one. We are one. We are not separate from God. But there are, amongst the manys, there is a difference of potency. Difference of potency. Just like what you can do, I cannot do. Your workmanship may not be equal with my workmanship. Your brain work may not be equal to my brain work. There are differences. Each and every living entity, they are different from each other. So far individual capacities are concerned. So in spite of many, that is God's creation, in spite of many, each and everything will find there is some difference. You can sit down at a place in New York and go on counting and seeing all people passing before you, you won't find one man is exactly like the other. Not only that, and in court, you know, everyone of you know that they take impression of the left hand thumb impression. And this thumb impression, you go on taking millions and millions of thumb impression, and you won't find one thumb impression is exactly like the other. And because there is difference of thumb impression, therefore the identity is taken in that way. That this particular man's thumb impression, even if he denies his signature, the thumb impression will collaborate that his signature is this. So that is God creation. Similarly, there are two kinds of expansions of the Lord. One kind of expansion is called Vishnu Tattva. Vishnu Tattva means the expansions, they are as equal as the God Himself. And there are expansions which are called the Jiva Tattva, a living entity. These expansion of the living entities, they are not equally powerful. But the expansion of Vishnu Tattva is equally powerful, as good as God Himself. So, the incarnation. Incarnation of God means the expansion which is as good as God Himself. That is called incarnation. So, this, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, is the expansion, incarnation, sound incarnation of God. It is expansion, and a plenary expansion, sound representation, not representation. God present Himself in this form of sound. Because we cannot see God with our present eyes. Present eyes, because this is not our proper eyes. They are material eyes. You don't think that this eye, the transparent thing which is floating in this, hole, that is not seeing. Similarly, if you can present, or if you take this eye, you cannot see, that cannot see. It is simply a lens only. It is only lens. So none of this bodily part is actually the thing which is taking part. So therefore, with this eyes, with this material eyes, you cannot see. Atas Sri Krishna Namadinabhavis Vrajya Indriya. The present senses cannot have any knowledge of the Supreme God. But how then we can have knowledge? If my senses are unfit, then how can I make it fit? Oh, that is the thing. That is the thing that you have to spiritualize this material sense and organs, and then when you spiritualize, then you can have the spiritual vision and see God and yourself. The same example which I have recited many times, just like the iron rod. Iron rod you put into the fire, it gets warm, warmer. And when it is red hot, then it is no longer iron. Iron it is, but it does not act as iron, but it acts as fire. That iron rod, which is red hot in association with fire, you can take that rod and touch anything, it will burn. That means it is no longer acting as iron, it is acting as fire. Similarly, if you associate with this transcendental incarnation, sound incarnation of God, then you will be gradually godly. It will be godly. You can become godly with God's association, not by any other material extraneous thing. No. Just like you can have fire only in association with fire, not with water. If you want to get yourself warm, then you have to associate with fire, not with water, not with air. Similarly, if you want to spiritualize your vision, if you want to spiritualize your action, if you want to spiritualize the whole constitution of your existence, then you have to associate with the Supreme Spirit. And that Supreme Spirit is very kind, because He is everything. that we have already explained. Everything is interrelated with the Supreme. Therefore, He is interrelated with sound also. So, by God's inconceivable potency, He can present before yourself in sound incarnation. That is His potency. He can do that. And therefore, this name, Krishna, and the Supreme Lord Krishna, there is no difference. So our, this sound representation of the Supreme Lord constantly will make us, just like our association with the fire, iron rods association with the fire makes the rod equally qualified. Exactly not equally qualified, but almost the quality of burning it gets. Similarly, by our constant association with Lord, Lord is not only incarnation in a sound form, and He is incarnated in many other forms. Just like Archa. Archa means the form of the Lord situated, established in some temple and worshipped. That is also incarnation of God. That is not idol worship. People who do not know that this is an authorized process of realizing God, or they have never tasted or practiced it, they cannot understand. They say, it is idol worship. No, it is not idol worship. I'll give you one example. Just like in the front of your door, there is a box, U.S. mail, it is written. And you put your letters within that box, and after a few days you get reply from your friend that I have received your letter and it is such and such, such and such. Now, if somebody puts another box like that, exactly, imitation, then why shall I spend postage to putting letters in this box, U.S. mail, I require postage. Why shall I not put up a box like that? Let me prepare a box like that so that it can go without postage. I want to save postage. Now he's going on putting letters in that without postage, and after some time he sees all the letters are lying there. It has not been dispatched. Because it is imitation. And the box which is supplied by the post office, that is authorized. In the matter, in material, you will find this box and that imitation box is the same thing. So this is a science, you see. Although we find that this form of the Lord, the Hindus, they have established one statue in the temple and they are worshipping as the Lord. How is that? Is it Lord? Is it stone? It is wood. But he does not know that because it is authorized, because it is authorizedly worshipped, therefore, even it is stone or wood, it can act. Just like the authorized post office, although seemingly it is a box which I can prepare, but it is acting because it is authorized. Similarly, the authorized symbol or representation of God is also God. is not different from God. Then why God is like that? It is His mercy. Because I cannot see God with my these eyes. I can see stone and wood and material things. Therefore, God is kind enough in a form suitable to my seeing and accept myself. It is His kindness. And besides that, if everything is God, because everything has a link with the God, with the Supreme Truth, then if God being omnipotent, why He cannot represent Himself in everything? If everything is God, everything is emanation of God, then God has got the power to manifest Himself in everything. That is His omnipotency. So these are considerations. So the explanation of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, is addressing the Supreme Lord through the energy. Hara, Hara is the energy, internal energy. Just like when there is, of course, in your country there is no sun worship, but in India there are persons who are sun worshippers. So they worship sun with so many things, and there is a lamp also. Now, this lamp is a light, but it is being offered for satisfying the sun. The sun is so lightful, this light is merely insignificant before the sunlight. It is still, because I have no other means, I am getting a sunlight, imitation of that light, and offering, and that offering is accepted. So these are spiritual conceptions when we gradually make our progressive advancement, these things will be realized. But for the present, we can take these instructions from authorized scripture. That atasya Krishna namadi navabhid gayam indriyai sevan mukhihi jivhado sameva spuratada. The God's name, God's form, God's quality, God's paraphernalia, God's entourage, like that. And anything in relation to God cannot be realized with our present senses. But when we are in service attitude, then God is so merciful, He is so pleased that our teeny efforts to realize Him attracts Him. And He becomes manifested gradually as we make our progress in spiritual service or devotional service. So this method, chanting of the transcendental name of the Supreme Lord, is a part of devotional service. There are 9 kinds of devotional services, of which Savanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Padasivanam Archanam Vandanam Dasam Satkham Atmanivedanam. These are different 9 processes. Savanam Kirtanam. Savanam means hearing. And kirtana means chanting. Chanting. So, by this process, just like I chant and you hear, and you chant and I hear. Parasparam, bodhantam parasparam. This is the factual activities of devotion in devotional society. This bodhantam parasparam. I chant, you hear, and you chant, I hear. So by this process, the transcendental name, the sound incarnation of the Supreme Lord, become manifest. Manifest so that we can realize God simply by chanting and hearing. Simply by chanting and hearing. That will be realized. Of course, there are some rules and regulations for chanting. But in the beginning, we haven't got to observe those rules and regulations at the present. First of all, let us have the taste for chanting. And then we shall be little careful that that the rules and regulations are followed. In the beginning, if we stick up to the rules and regulations are subordinate things. That's like you enter into your office. You are appointed in some office to work. So on the very day, you do not know all the rules and regulations. Because you do not know all the rules and regulations, that does not mean that you cannot be appointed. First of all, let yourself be appointed. Now working yourself, you know that rules and regulations. This is the rule, this is the regulation. Just like in my life, I'll say one instance. When I met my spiritual master, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj, so as a gentleman means as a gentleman, so he was sitting in a coach like that. So and I also sat down on that very coach. So I did not know that what are the rules and regulations. Now, when I saw that his other disciples are coming and they are sitting down, so I thought myself, oh, I have done this wrong. I should not have sat with his divine grace. So, of course, I did not get down immediately, but I took it, and from next day I did not sit. So rules and regulations automatically was taught. So that rules and regulations is not very important. The important is, the thing is that we must take up. The first rules and regulation is that we must have some attachment for this. Attachment for this. Then automatically rules and regulations we shall learn. There will be no difficulty. So this transcendental sound, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, you don't think that I have come here, it is my personal manufacture. No, it's not my personal manufacture. It's authorized, just like the post box. It's authorized because all previous acharyas, all previous authorized persons in this line, they have done it. Just like, see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is chanting and dancing. Chanting and dancing. It is the same thing. This picture is before you, so that gradually when you feel ecstasy, you will also dance like him. And when you automatically dance, then you know that the thing is already realized. Not artificially, but when you feel, oh, let me dance. It is so much ecstatic, let me dance. Nothing should be done artificially. Let everything come automatically. And only we have to follow Mahajana Jina Gatasya Pantha. Dharmasya tattang nihitam guhayam Mahajina Gatasya Pantha. This is a verse from scripture that tarko apratishtha. If you simply go on arguing about a spiritual matter. This is not, this is not, this is not, this is, yes, this is not, I say something, you say something. No, no, no. You cannot realize spiritual objects simply by the speculation argument. Our argument, our logical, strength has no access in the spiritual world. The Vedic mantra says, Nāyam ātma pravacane na labhya, na medhaya na bhuna sutena. Ātma, the Supreme Self, cannot be realized. Pravacane na. Suppose I am very expert speaker, I can present things very nicely, but without any substance. That won't help you. Simply by jugglery of words, if I can captivate you, that won't help you. Nāmātmā pravacanena, this is pravacan. Of course, we are delivering speeches from authoritative book, Bhagavad Gita. I am not speaking before you of my own imagination. I am speaking from the authorized book. Therefore, it is not exactly pravacan. Neither I am squeezing out some meaning for my purpose. I am just presenting you the same principle, Mahajana Jena Gatasya Pantha. As Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu preached, I am trying to present the same thing before you in a different language only, that's all. Because in India he preached in Sanskrit. He was a very learned scholar in formerly any big man, any big scholar, they would be big scholar in Sanskrit. The Sanskrit was the written language. In the beginning of the British period, Sanskrit was the written language. It is the policy of Lord Macaulay that he transformed the whole attitude. They made a plan that if Indians remain as Indians, then we cannot rule over. We must make them Anglicized. So that policy was followed for 200 years. So India has lost its original culture. Therefore, the original point is that tarko pratishtha, we cannot realize the supreme truth simply by argument or logical presentation or philosophical speculation. No. Tarko pratishtha srutayo vibhinna. Srutayo means scriptures. Now, say for example, Bhagavad Gita and your Bible and the Mohammedans, they will present Quran. So, of course, when this Bhagavad Gita is a little different from Vedic scripture that we have already explained. It is a independent something, universal. So, Vedic scripture, Quran, Bible, or Zoroastrian, there are so many religions, Buddhist religions, so many. So there may be some difference of opinion. Srutayo vibhinna. Vibhinna means difference. Now, you cannot realize the absolute truth simply by your mundane arguments and by your logical strength. Neither you can catch up the right thing by reading different scriptures. Srutayo vibhinna. Naso munit jasya matangna bhinnam. And if you follow great philosophers, great thinkers, then also you will find one thinker is different from another thinker. One philosopher is differing from another philosopher. So whom to follow? This philosopher says the God is person, another philosopher says God is the impersonal, another philosopher says that God is everywhere. There is no separate existence of God. So many philosophies there are in the world. And one person is not actually philosopher if he does not differ from other philosophers. That is the philosophical basic principle. You are a philosopher. If I cannot make your philosophical conclusion null and void and make my philosophy established, then I am not a philosopher. You see? That is the way going on. Naso munit jasya matangana bhinnam. He is not a philosopher if he cannot present a separate theory. He is not a philosopher. Then how to catch up the absolute truth? What is the way? Dharmasya tattam nihitam guhayam. Therefore, the absolute truth is concealed within your heart. Nihitam guhayam. Now, mahajana jena gatasya pantha. You just try to follow the great personalities, what they are doing. What they are doing. Now about this Mahajan, there is also difference of opinion who is Mahajan. And so far our Vedic culture is concerned, there are a specific mention, Mahajan. And so far Lord Krishna is concerned, so there is no two opinions about his authority throughout the whole world. So far we are concerned, Hindus or the followers of the Vedic religion, there is no difference of opinion so far Krishna's authority is concerned. There are five authorities, recognized authorities in India. So far, this is spiritual life is concerned. One of them is Sri Ramanujacharya, and other is Shankaracharya. The other is Madhyacharya, other is Vishnushyami, and other is Nimbaditya. Principally, the whole, some of them, a flowerist say 2000 years before, some of them 1500 years before, some of them 1100 years before, there are different ages they have come. But all of them, in spite of their coming in different ages, they all are in one opinion, Krishnastu Bhagavan Sam. Krishna, Lord Krishna, is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Just like we have cited, Ishara Parama Krishna, the Supreme Controller, the Supreme Lord, is Krishna. Now, you can see from his presentation of this Bhagavad Gita, how supreme he is. He spoke this truth 5,000 years before, and continually for 5,000 years, all scholars are studying these scriptures and studying very devotedly to understand it. You know our present president in India, Dr. Radha Krishna, he is a renowned scholar of the world, Dr. Radha Krishna. When he came into your country, your president, late Mr. Kennedy, he welcomed him as his own teacher. Because when Mr. Kennedy was a student in the Oxford University, Dr. Radha Krishna was a visiting professor. In the open meeting, Mr. Kennedy admitted that now Dr. Radha Krishna has come as the president, that he is always my teacher. He's still my teacher. It was very kind of him that he received him as a teacher, not as contemporary. See, even that Dr. Radha Krishna, he is also studying this Bhagavad Gita it's profound. You know your Professor Einstein, he was a profound student of this Bhagavad Gita. Hitler was a great student of Bhagavad Gita. So many in all the country. There are so many Mohammedans in India. Oh, they are a devout student of Bhagavad Gita. I know one doctor, Ibrahim, from Allahabad University. Oh, he is so devoted to Lord Krishna that on the birthday of Lord Krishna, he must write one nice article and publish in the paper. So, this instruction, that Mahajana Jena Gatasya Pantha, we cannot have the knowledge of the absolute truth simply by argument or simply by philosophy or simply by big brain or speaking power. No, all these things will not do. Simply, we have to follow the great authority. Yeah, Lord Krishna, Lord Chaitanya, he introduced this Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, for this age. And he recommended, Kalo, not recommended by his own brain, but it is recommended in the scripture, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Iva Kevalam, Kalo, Nasteva, 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 Gatidanmatha. If you want to realize the Supreme Truth, then you must chant this, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Whenever you get, say, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Iva Kevalam, only this. And if you think of only this, why not other? No. Kalo nasteva, nasteva, nasteva gatinannata. Nasteva means there is no alternative. And he repeats this, no alternative, no alternative, no alternative. Three times. That means he is giving too much stress. Our process is like that we are following a great personality, Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He introduced from the scripture, not in his own way. Nothing should be accepted which is not recognized, you see. So this is recognized method. Now, it depends on us. Yeah, let us follow this process and see how we are making progress in the spiritual path. Thank you very much. It is. Now, if there is any question, you can ask.